Let's look at the manufacturing process for single-sided versus double-sided boards and see how you can save money in manufacturing by following a few simple design guidelines. First, let's look at SMT boards. Putting components on both sides means you have to take two passes through manufacturing. First, one side gets stenciled. Then goes to pick and place. Then to solder reflow. And finally, inspection. And then we have to repeat the entire process for the second side of the board. So we've essentially doubled the manufacturing effort. Now let's consider mixed technology boards. These always require two different processes, one for the SMT components and one for the through-hole components. But it's still best to put all the components on the same side. This means we can do a regular SMT process, followed by a regular through-hole process with manual or automatic insertion, wave solder, and inspection. But if it's really not possible to get all of the components on one side, then the second best approach is to place all of the SMT components on one side and all of the through-hole components on the other. But with a double-sided board, the through-hole side will need special fixtures or hand soldering, with higher costs and lower throughput. Finally, let's consider through-hole boards. With all components on one side, we need just one pass through the standard through-hole manufacturing process. If we have a second side, we go through the process a second time, but this time the board can't go through wave solder, so we have to do selective soldering, or hand soldering. Again, higher cost and lower throughput. Double-sided boards are fine when they are necessary, but often, spending a little more time on the design and layout can eliminate the need for a second side and save a lot of money in the manufacturing costs over the life of the product. Contact Z-Axis for more information about design optimized for manufacturing cost.